story, Biden's secret doc scandal. President Biden keeps playing kind of a no-see-em game about the growing classified document story, taking it to a whole new level in a short statement that he made yesterday in California. Listen.
We found a handful of documents were filed in the wrong place. We immediately turned them over to the archives of the Justice Department. We're fully cooperating, looking forward to getting this resolved quickly. I think you're going to find there's nothing there. I have no regrets. I'm following what the lawyers have told me they want me to do. It's exactly what we're doing. There's no there there.
So, folks, there's nothing to see here, just a handful of documents that were filed in the wrong place. He's not even mentioning that the docs were classified. Just ignore it all. Don't even look. There's no here. There's no there there or here here. It's kind of like the video of that kid denying that he ate any cupcakes, even though his mouth is covered with crumbs. Of course, that was funny. This is some very serious stuff here, but he's still trying to get away with it by joshing and denying that anything's wrong. Another come on, man, kind of moment from good old Joe. Only this time, it's not going to be so easy. A new special counsel is going to remind him that at the very least, he broke the law by taking classified docs out of the White House when he was vice president. He may also get reprimanded for colluding with the Justice Department to prevent the FBI from overseeing the removal of classified documents by his unsecured personal lawyers. And of course, new Judiciary Chairman Jim Jordan is going to be holding hearings on the whole matter shortly. Even the press is beginning to cave into the reality of it all. And even if there aren't more sinister reasons for his actions, he's clearly lost the charm that he once had to talk his way out of this. There are too many telltale crumbs around all this, and they all lead directly to good old Joe doing something wrong. So the no-see-em game clearly won't work this time. Here to add some solid legal context to my informal description of what's going on here, we turn to former federal prosecutor Andy McCarthy. Andy, thank you for coming in. I mean, you know, it's just you can't deal with this situation the way he kind of talked his way out of so many others, can you?
Well, not anymore, David, because and largely it's because of the Trump classified documents business. You know, what they're hoping, I think, is that what they said during the Hillary Clinton days is going to sway people. Back then, they basically tried to rewrite the law so that they wouldn't have to apply it to her. So even though what the law says is that if you're grossly negligent in mishandling classified documents, if you take them to an unprotected place, if you store them in an unauthorized place, if you expose them to people who don't have security clearances, that's gross negligence. It's a felony under the law, and you could be prosecuted. But with Hillary, they told people that, no, you have to have an intent to sell the country out to our enemies and all this other jazz, which, of course, is not true. Biden's hoping that that's what people think. The problem is, ever since August at the Mar-a-Lago raid, they've been telling people that it's a terrible felony for Trump to have kept these classified documents in an unauthorized place. So I don't think that's a bell they can unring at this point.
Even though, of course, Trump was president when he took those documents out, Joe Biden was vice president when he took his documents out. That kind of changes things as well, doesn't it?
To me, it really doesn't. I mean, I hear that argument made all the time that, you know, Trump had the authority to declassify and Biden didn't. There's no reason to think Trump did declassify. There's no evidence of that. There's evidence that cuts against that. And, you know, Biden couldn't declassify. But the point is they had classified documents in a place where they're not allowed to have them. And that, you know, should be the bottom line for my money.
Well, the big difference between Hillary and Donald Trump and everything, this is an incident of somebody who has classified documents who is the current president of the United States. And right. There are a lot of questions about that came out this week because of that Wall Street Journal article where they got information that there was this conference between the DOJ and at the very least Biden's counsels, but probably Biden himself might have been involved in some way. To hold back the FBI from overseeing the collection of these documents from people who didn't have the security clearance to look over the documents, but the FBI was held back by the DOJ. What do you make of all that?
Yeah. Well, I think it's really grossly negligent, which happens to be the term of art in the statute. It's ironic because what the Justice Department is investigating is the crime of being grossly negligent in mishandling classified documents, yet they knew that there were documents. They had reason to believe there were other documents in other Biden locations. They had the opportunity and I think the duty to have the FBI oversee any kind of search in that regard. I'm fine with the idea that it was it would have been rash of Garland to do a search warrant at that point because this was all unfolding and new. But that didn't mean he didn't have grounds for a search warrant, which means if the Biden people are cooperating like they say they are, there was no reason not to do a consent search, with the kind that happens all the time, where the FBI could be present with his lawyers. And if there were classified documents, make sure that only they saw them and seized them and nobody else did. But how the Justice Department would not do that is just, I find it mind-boggling.
Well, you say gross negligence. Could it be something beyond that, Andy? Could it possibly be obstruction of justice? I mean, we know that some of these documents dealt with Ukraine, China. These are things that, the Biden family had a great interest in terms of knowing how much the government knew about corruption with Burisma, for example. We know that Hunter Biden was staying at the residence. I mean, there are reasons to suspect that there could be an obstruction of justice going on here, aren't there?
Well, you have to have a judicial proceeding that it's relevant to for it to be obstruction of justice. So I don't know, you know, interfering with intelligence operations is a bad thing to do, but it's not obstruction of justice. And on the other hand, violating the Espionage Act is a 10-year felony, which is a pretty serious felony. So if I were the prosecutor, I'd be homing in on what I have and what I know I can prove, which is that he's had these documents. You know, he didn't have this office at the Penn Biden Center until February of 2018, which means these documents have to have been in another unauthorized location before they were in that one. And then the one thing, the common denominator, David, that ties it all together is every single personal place is Biden's place. He's the thing. He's the, you know, the main thing that ties all of this
together. Well, I got to tell you, if in fact these documents that he had related to a case that his son was involved in, I think there are some grounds for a possibility of obstruction of justice. I just want to switch gears very quickly, Andy, to something that happened with the Supreme Court today. We had the Supreme Court saying they give up. They couldn't find the leaker with the decision on the abortion decision that was made, the initial draft document that came out. Here's what Senator Kennedy said about all this earlier on our network. Let me play the tape for you. Roll it.
Here's my message to the leaker. Congratulations, butthead. You almost got a member of the United States Supreme Court killed in his family. I think we can find the leaker. Maybe the Supreme Court needs to bring in help, but we need to find that leaker, make an example of him or her, and knock them, hit them so hard they'll cough up bones.
Hit them so hard they'll cough up bones. I mean, that's typical of Kennedy. But should we let the matter rest, or should we continue an investigation to find out who the leaker was?
Well, you know, Chief Justice Roberts says the matter is not resting. They're continuing to follow leads, but they're not very helpful. David, I think we talked about this when it first happened. And my position from the beginning has been this had to be a criminal investigation aggressively pursued by the Justice Department with the FBI. And the thing was that the left and the Biden administration didn't want to pursue it that way because they liked the leak. I know they pretend at times that they don't. But what they were hoping was that the leak would have the effect that the leaker hoped it would have, which is that it would intimidate the justices on the court to change what appeared to be the decision in the case. So I don't see, you know, they don't, the only people who can approach this as a criminal investigation are the Justice Department and the FBI. The court doesn't have the capacity to do that. They can't put people in the grand jury. They can't give them immunity. They can't prosecute them. They can't do the things that you do to advance an investigation.
It all gets back to blind justice, and I'm afraid we're losing a lot of our concept of blind justice here in the United States. Andy, thank you very much for being here. Have a great weekend. Appreciate it.